It's Wednesday, September 29th, 2010. I'm Kevin McShane, and this is the McShane Sports Beat Report. Seizing your opportunity for success may be one of the most difficult and challenging things you'll ever have to do as a professional athlete. Your will to succeed may be outstanding, and your determination to realize success may be stellar, but no matter how hard you try, sometimes it's hard to make a positive first impression. For former Buffalo Bills quarterback Trent Edwards, his sand, it is hourglass and his opportunity to be the permanent starting signal caller in Western New York has run dry. The Bills released Edwards on Monday in a surprising and unexpected move, just weeks after first-year Bills head coach Chad Gailey said he saw light at the end of the tunnel with Edwards as his starter. After the way Fitz played yesterday, I feel very confident about the direction we're going, Gailey said on Monday, a day after the Bills had suffered their third defeat of the season at the hands of the New England Patriots, 38-30. Trent did the best he could. He's a great young man, and I wish him the best, he said. ESPN's NFL insider Adam Schefter is reporting that the Bills put Edwards on the trading block recently in hopes of receiving some compensation before releasing him. In order to fill his roster spot, the team plans to re-sign quarterback Levi Brown, a player they drafted in the 7th round of the 2010 NFL Draft. Even though the Bills came out on the losing end of the scoreboard on Sunday, Fitzpatrick was able to move the offense efficiently. He passed for 247 yards, and as an offense, Buffalo was able to gain a total of 374 yards, which is more yards than production that Edwards was able to produce in two starts to start the season. Two NFL league executives told ESPN's NFL insider Chris Mortensen that they expect Edwards to be claimed off waivers by 4 p.m. on Tuesday. The Jacksonville Jaguars, Carolina Panthers, Kansas City Chiefs, New York Jets, and Seattle Seahawks are all expected to put in a claim for Edwards' services. Waiver claims are still based currently on last year's win-loss total. After this weekend's slate of games, they'll be based on 2010, win-loss totals. Edwards' base salary for the 2010 season stands at $1.65 million, and the Bills have already paid him a total of $291,176. Any team that claims Edwards would owe him the rest. Edwards was in his first season in Buffalo after being selected by the team in the third round of the 2007 NFL Draft. He was eventually replaced by J.P. Lossman midway through his rookie year. He had a record of 14-18 as a starter for Buffalo. Edwards found himself riding a pine after 2 weeks of the NFL season thanks to a couple of dismal performances. In a week one loss, 15-10, to the Miami Dolphins, Edwards could only muster a total of 139 yards through the air. He did have a touchdown. A week later, however, in Green Bay, he regressed further, throwing for only 102 yards, and he had 2 interceptions in a 34-7 drubbing at the hands of the Packers. This will mark the second time in consecutive seasons that Edwards has lost his job in favor of Fitzpatrick. Edwards had no comment on his release on Monday. Bills receiver Roscoe Parrish says the release of Edwards won't serve as a distraction for him or his teammates, even though it came as a sudden surprise. He was our starting quarterback 2 weeks ago, and now something like this happens. We have to move on. We can't dwell on that, Parrish said. As Edwards' successor, Fitzpatrick says he's excited to embrace the opportunity to become the new starting quarterback for the Buffalo Bills. However, he admits it's bittersweet because he's losing a close personal friend. I think it caught everybody off guard. Trent, a well-respected and well-liked guy in the locker room. Personally for me, this one's tough because we spend so much time together. He'll rebound and move on from this, and we'll move forward, Fitzpatrick said. Gailey says he understands why some Bills fans may be scratching their heads over the latest personnel moves in Buffalo. However, he says that releasing Edwards was the best decision for the future success of the football team. I could see where people could look at that and wonder what's going on here, but I felt as we looked at it and evaluated everything we had seen up until this point, this was the direction for the future of our football team, he said. Trent Edwards' time in Buffalo was marked by injuries, inconsistency, and a lack of difference makers in both the skill positions and along the offensive line. Simply put, the Buffalo Bills did not do a good enough job of protecting their quarterback and keeping him upright and surrounding him with the necessary tools in order to be successful. It's the end of a chapter which had such a promising beginning, but ends so tragically. Edwards will now most likely be relegated to a backup role for the remainder of his career, unless he can prove to an NFL team, and for that matter the league, that he can be a solid starting quarterback. Some may argue that he hasn't even proved that yet during his 4 years in the league, and I would tend to concur. He has some talent, but now it's up to him to go fishing to try and find a team that's willing to dive into the deep end with him. Kevin McShann, McShann Sports Beat, reports.